Niamh, I have a question from Aisling from School Katrina, and she wants to know what kind of person makes a good engineer, firstly, and secondly, what she wants to know, what do you like most and least about your job?
They're two great questions. Okay, what makes a good engineer? I think it's what Bart actually touched on earlier, is what makes a good engineer is somebody that's curious. I think everybody's curious, actually, off the bat, but just to embrace your curiosity, and that, you know, that curiosity to actually take things apart and try to figure out how things work. I think if you're that kind of person, you're a natural engineer before you even have to study books. And then I think a logical mind. So it's like taking that and taking it a step further. So what I have found that I've used again and again and again in all my different aspects of work is that logical mind. I've fallen back on it again and again. So it's that ability to approach anything and to go, how do I understand this? And just break it down into chapters. That thinking is what makes a good engineer, because you can apply it anywhere. And what do I like most about my job and what do I like least? What I like least about my job is that I'm freelance, so I never know when my next gig is coming. So that kind of is a little bit scary, because I don't do the 9-to-5 structure that a lot of people would have as their careers. And what I love most about it is exactly the same thing.
Absolutely.
As the fact I don't know when my next job is going to be. So.
Yeah. The excitement of it.
The excitement of it.
The unknown.
Yeah, and the fear.
Oh. And Rachel, we have a question from Keane Charlton. And he's from St. Louis Community College, and he wants to know, what kind of things could a student do now to get started about thinking, studying a degree in engineering?
There's so much they can do. I think, you know, Patrick touched on industry placement, but, you know, even if we're to go back into maybe second level, transition year programs that offer placements for 2 weeks, I think often it can help you actually rule out somewhere, you know, as opposed to rule in, which I think is even better sometimes, because it can, you know, reduces your options. I think summer placements, speaking to engineers can be really, really helpful. You know, this is going to be really useful, but actually sitting down with somebody and, you know, having a chat with them about what do you do on a daily basis, what do you like about it, that can really help. And then other little things, I suppose, in terms of your CV, it's funny, more and more we have clients coming to us now asking, okay, they're graduates, what are their hobbies and interests? Mm-hmm. Were they in team activities? Yeah. Were they a team leader? Leadership skills, teamwork skills, do they have a language? We're dealing with more and more countries and, you know, more cultures all the time. So all these little things can actually make a difference. So, you know, small things you can do, industry placement, making sure you have a nice little CV and you're involved in a few activities, and that's kind of what I'd recommend.
Great. So nice rounded people is what
we're
looking for,
yes.
As well.
Yeah.
Sure. Brilliant. So Bart, just while we're on the topic of actually what it is that young people can do to get into a field of engineering, your field of engineering, renewable energy, yeah, is really, really hot and really controversial at the moment, I suppose. Can young people do things now to get involved in that?
I think if you've an interest in sustainability and an interest in reducing energy usage and also an interest in making a difference as well, mm-hmm, I'm in the industry because I believe you can't keep burning traditional fossil fuels like coal and gas.
Sure.
And that you have to start finding alternatives to produce electricity and energy. So that's the reason I'm in this sector, and I believe it's going to grow, continue to grow strongly, because I don't think there's any other choice for electricity in the future. In terms of what you can do, I agree with the guys earlier. I think people who are good team players in an engineering degree in college, you're going to spend a lot of your time in groups, and good engineers can work well in groups to solve problems and write reports together and share knowledge. That's the secret to good engineering. So teamwork on the one side, and then also a passion or an interest in solving problems. Not necessarily fixing things, that's quite narrow, I think, as well, which I was interested in, but also solving any problems, which is why I think an engineering degree is so attractive to careers that people wouldn't think are engineering. Banks are very interested in hiring engineers because we're very good problem solvers and we have math skills. So an engineering degree is a very good basis for lots of different careers because you're good problem solvers.
Excellent. Thank you.